Graduation occupies a very, very special place in the academic calendar. It's a proud moment for all of us, and you have every reason to be proud. We threw tons of books at you, we poked you, we nudged you, tested and examined you, and you most likely also sometimes had the feelings we got on your nerves. But you survived it, and obviously also enjoyed it, because you're all sitting here and beaming. Graduation is all about celebrating your achievements. However, before we do so, allow me a minute of reflection. To say that we are today living in challenging times would be quite an understatement. We have a tragic war raging in Europe. We hear politicians and analysts again discussing nuclear war options, a discussion that I thought has been long relegated to textbooks. COVID-19 is not really behind us, at least not in all parts of the world. And we are, by some accounts, entering into a worldwide recession. In the words of the famous German historian Reinhard Koselleck, the space of experience and the horizon of expectation no longer match. What we know from yesterday, the past, no longer allows us to confidently plan the future. The rupture is simply too big. A world where suddenly everything seems possible can be very scary. Did we at Webster help you prepare for such a world, which you will occupy much longer than we will? Did we teach you the skills to achieve your objectives in a world that seems to be spinning much, much faster than yesterday? Did we equip you with what it takes to lead a fulfilled life? If you have the impression that Webster taught you to be critical, the written or the spoken word, then we succeeded. If the diverse student body, students from over 70 nations, taught you something about tolerance, patience, made you curious about other countries and traditions, then we succeeded. If you're thinking before you're speaking, know that opinions are not facts, then we succeeded. And if we taught you how to cut through the maze of information that is available today, then we succeeded. Those skills, critical thinking, tolerance, curiosity, reflection, make a good academic. Don't forget that with an academic title, you're part of an elite. Roughly 7% of the world population have an academic degree. Without doubt, many more would have the intellectual capacity, but were never fortunate enough to pursue such a degree. Thus, we should be all the more thankful for the opportunity we got and aware of the obligations such a degree brings with it. What is this obligation? Don't take shortcuts. Use your skills. Be critical. Be curious and trust yourself. Now, graduation is, of course, also an opportunity to say thanks. First, it is up to us, faculty and staff, to thank you, students, that you allowed us to accompany you on parts of your journey, a journey that will lead you, I'm convinced, to a fulfilled life and a happy life. Secondly, I want to thank faculty and staff who went out of their way to support you, to make your time at Webster not only a time of intensive studying, but also a time where you forged bonds and friendships that will last for a very, very long time. And last but not least, let us together thank families and friends who supported you on this joint adventure and made this proud moment possible for us. Please join me for an applause. Now comes the part some of you have been intensively waiting for. So last year I ended my speech with a quote from someone called Swedish House Mafia. This year's, and I can tell you it is getting more difficult every year, this year the search for a proper quote was really difficult. The words do not always make sense to me. The lyrics are not really complex. So I had the choice between ah ha 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 and la da la da da da. That is not good enough, so it's a quote from someone called Miley Cyrus. It's a brand new start, a dream come true. Congratulations to all of you, and may the force be with you.